Hello everyone and welcome back. With this tutorial, we are introducing a new idea of making animations in PowerPoint by drawing the sketch on paper first, and then later animating them into the PowerPoint. The animation we are using for illustration is inspired by the work of Kate Nielsen at Dribbble.com. So, how do we get started? First, you need to draw all the different poses or parts of the character on paper. Just like my younger daughter, Sahani Kohli, did for this eye blinking animation. I asked her to draw four separate layers for this project. For instance, the goggles, the eye pupil, eyebrows, and closed eyes. Once you have your drawing ready on paper, take a picture from your mobile, or scan the paper and then import that into your PC. Open PowerPoint and take a new blank presentation and then change the layout to blank. Insert the picture by moving to the Insert tab, clicking the picture's drop-down menu, and choosing this device. Browse for the location where your paper photo or scanned copy is saved, and then insert that into your presentation. Select the picture and crop the unnecessary part from the Picture Format tab. As we have drawn four separate layers, so we need to make a few copies of this image, so we may separate each part as a separate layer. Like, our first layer will be the goggles. So, I will crop the rest of the layers from this scanned image. After cropping the image, resize it to the size that you want for the animation, and align it to the center and middle of the slide. Now, make a duplicate of this slide, and use the crop command again to only have the eye pupils. We need to make two layers for the eye pupils, so we may place them separately in the eyes behind the goggles. As you might know that PowerPoint only allows cropping pictures in rectangular form. So, if we crop both layers using the crop command, then there will remain a white space around the pupils, as our scanned image is not a transparent picture. So, if you place them on top of the eyes behind the goggles, then the sharp edges can be seen around the pupil, which we don't want. So, we need to do custom cropping for the eye pupils, so they may fit right into the eyes without any sharp edges. There are certain methods to do this, but we will use the freeform shape from the shapes drop-down menu of the Insert tab and we'll draw an outline around each eye. Now, select the picture and then hold down the Shift key, and then from the Shape Format tab, use the Intersect command from the Merge Shapes drop-down menu. Do the same for the second eye pupil. Once you have the cropped eye pupils, then you can easily place them on top of the eyes and can rotate and resize them easily. You can follow the same method to create separate layers for the eyebrows and closed eyes. Once you have all the layers, then you just need to create different slides, each having a different pose. On the first slide, we will have the eye pupil's eyes on the left side. On the second slide, we will display closed eyes. The third slide is a duplicate of the first slide, so you can right-click on the slide in the thumbnail view, choose the duplicate command, and then drag and drop to change the position. On the fourth slide, we will place the eye pupils in the middle of the eyes. On the fifth slide, the pupils are on the right side. And again for the sixth slide, you can replicate the first slide. Now, select all the slides from the thumbnail view by holding the Shift key, and then move to the Transitions tab. Here uncheck the option on mouse click, and then make a checkmark on after under Advanced slide. The time duration could be of your choice that how fast or slow you want the animation to play. We are using a time of 1 second for each slide. See the slideshow and there you have a nice eye blinking animation ready. From the Slideshow tab, click Setup Slideshow, and then make a checkmark on the loop continuously until Escape key is pressed, option to have an infinite loop of the animation. And if you will export this presentation as a GIF file from the File menu's Export option, then it will create an infinite loop of the animation. So, if you are good at drawing things on paper rather than on a computer, then you can use this method to animate things from paper to PowerPoint. I hope you will find this idea interesting and informative. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Subscribe to our channel to keep in touch for the upcoming tutorials. Thanks a lot for watching and have a great day.